relationship with her stalker.
Dirty kiss.
ABBA Behind the Blonde, next Tuesday at 10 on 4.
New comedy from the lab. Tonight, disabled performers get funny at 11:40 after Fat Q on 4.
Go on, touch it. It won't bite.
Welcome to Fat Q. Tonight's host, David Mitchell.
Joining me tonight to answer my frequently asked questions are Catherine Jakeways, Rhys Thomas, Henning Vane, and Frankie Boyle. Now, this week, it's been revealed that Paris Hilton, the glamorous heiress and waste of fucking space, is... is so lazy... is so lazy that she won't even read the menus in restaurants. She has them read to her by the waiter, thus freeing up precious energy for carrying her dog and making sex films. So, are you as lazy as Miss Hilton? My frequently asked question is this. What's the laziest thing you've ever done? What's the laziest thing you've done, Rhys?
Nothing.
Oh, yes. Hey! Do that. Yeah.
That was like blind date there.
Oh, good answer, number three.
Frankie Boyle.
Well, I saw in a shop a packet of condoms that are for people with premature ejaculation, and basically they've got an anaesthetic in the lining, so it makes you numb and you can last for longer. And I saw those, and I thought, you could wear one inside out and you wouldn't have to wake anybody up.
Also, I know somebody who was in a restaurant, so it's continuing the Paris Hilton theme.
Yeah.
Was in a restaurant and needed to get the sugar, and he was so lazy that he couldn't get a waiter over and he couldn't want to go up and stand up and get the sugar. So he actually got his mobile out and phoned Yellow Pages to get the phone number of the restaurant and phoned the front desk and asked them to bring some sugar to table six.
That's not lazy, that's...
But it's quite innovative,
quite enterprising. What, Henning, what's the laziest thing you've ever done? Or ever not done, or for what period, you know?
Don't really want to talk about that. I mean, if I do that, really must stay between us.
Yeah, absolutely will.
Once.
I can guarantee that.
Once, but then, I mean, really embarrassed about it. So, but it was years ago, and therefore I just dared to tell it. Well, it happened there. I was supposed to get up at 6 o'clock in the morning.
Yes.
So, but what happened then, because I was working so hard the previous day, I only got up 5 past.
You lazy bastard. 5 past 6. What about the people who were waiting for you? What did they do for 5 minutes?
I felt so bad.
What were you doing that day? What were you having to get up for?
Just getting up to work.
What,
so because what, some people have got duties.
You had a comedy gig at 6:15, didn't you?
Nah, I went to my steel manufacturer and got the shovel and did the garden. Yeah. You...
Anyway, I don't understand that, Paris Hilton. All that money and she works on a farm. Now, today saw the state opening of Parliament, the highlight of Black Rod's year. The first business of the new Parliament is identity cards. If Tony Blair has his wicked way, it will become an offence for anyone not to carry an ID card. So my frequently asked question is, are ID cards good for Britain? Henning.
Well, I think then in regards to that IT thing, I mean, the trouble is it's all good and well discussing whether that should be introduced or not. But the question is, I mean, Britain, will they be capable of introducing that system? So if then, prior to the electoral vote, election there, so they had to admit that the whole postal vote system was didn't work whatsoever, and they had to bring in people from other countries to look after the election process here. I mean, how the hell do they want to introduce that in ID card?
You're saying we're not organized enough. to do ID cards. Is that what you're saying? We can't get our shit together enough to give everyone... We only have to give 60 million people a little piece of card.
Yeah, we can do that. I honestly don't think that Britain is capable of doing that.
Yes, we can.
Do they have ID cards in Germany?
Of course. Do you want to see it?
Yeah. Oh,
I've got mine on me, of course.
Get it out.
That was my ID card.
Oh, there you go. I don't know. I don't know if you, that's what they say on TV, isn't it? I don't know if we can see that.
But, come in closer, Ron. No, that is. I will say the names of the cameramen as well.
That, that's an ID card there.
And look, that's me.
It sort of shines because it's genuine.
You
photograph very well.
Yeah, there was for
how much did that cost you? Yeah.
That thing there is a tenner, I reckon.
No, but
or that photo.
Because I know I'm not opposed to ID cards at all.
So why do you want them?
I want them because I think it would be a safer place if we've all got an ID card, because you've got nothing to hide, you're not worried about showing your card.
But that we have to do a thing. You shouldn't have laws saying we have to do things. There are some things which you have to have... Right. I think everyone should be, wherever possible, allowed to do whatever the hell they like.
Right.
Until whatever the hell they like starts to stop other people being able to do whatever the hell they like. So, giving people the freedom to murder isn't a good idea, because then that reduces other people's freedom not to be murdered.
What's he going
to
do with ID card?
And giving someone the freedom to rob things takes away other people's freedom to own property, right?
I hate you.
Now, why does the freedom not to carry a piece of card because Tony Blair says so, why does that freedom impinge on anyone else's freedom?
Because...
We've never had ID cards before. We're fine.
Exactly, but look at all the terrorism attacks that's happened.
What all the terrorism attacks?
30 years of Ireland.
30 Years of Ireland is an album which Rhys is releasing later this year, where he has his own unique racist take on the folk songs of the Republic of Ireland.
But look. You had a better education than me, because you went to fucking that... The big school.
He went to the little school, which was actually just a pond.
Yeah, he went to the...
We're dipping you in the learning, Rhys.
He went to Hogwarts.
Can I make one point? Make one further point in favour of the ID card? So, because I'm the best example that ID card is a good thing. So, because I've got one and I haven't killed a person in my life.
Frankie.
I quite look forward to having my identity stolen by terrorists. I'd love to have someone from Al-Qaeda having to pay my child support. It was Blinkett wanted to bring this in, wasn't it? Like it was going to help him identify anyone.
Oh, he's got hands.
They should have just told him, yeah, no, we brought that in. we've done that. And just hand him the King of Diamonds and say, that's your one. Show that whenever you go anywhere.
You'd have to have your name and address stitched across your head to help him out, wouldn't you?
Where are you from?
Yeah, because it's stupid, isn't it? You can't tell people to do things just because you say if you don't do things, you might get blown up.
We can identify people anyway. It's not like you're always meeting people and going, I'm not sure about his identity. He told me he was called David. Is he called David? I'm not sure.
And also, it's not clear at what stage in the process of arranging a terrorist outrage anyone is going to ask you for your identity card. Is it when you're actually assembling the bomb or sneaking up to hide it or running away from the scene that a bobby is going to appear from behind a post box and say, I'm sorry, sir, could I have a look at your papers? You know, it's almost like if they're happy to blow us up, they might break the law about carrying ID cards as well. So, do you think ID cards are yet another step towards a police state? Here's the countdown of questions to ask if you think Big Brother might be watching you. In at number 5, does your 8-year-old nephew keep asking you questions about your political beliefs for a school project? At number 4, do policemen know your name just by scanning the barcode on the back of your neck? At number 3, if you try to take the mirror off the wall, does a voice shout, leave it? And number 2, does your dog's eye look a bit more like a camera than it did yesterday? And the number 1 question you should ask yourself if you think Big Brother is watching you is, are you making your own dinner tonight, but only because you've just denounced your wife to the thought police? Traitorous cow. On this show, the questions we like asking are those that are being most frequently asked. But we also like to make room for questions that aren't being asked as much, but perhaps ought to be. What would you call them? Infrequently asked questions? Yes. That's what you'd call them. So, what's your infrequently asked question, Frankie?
Why isn't that John Leslie on Celebrity Love Island?
Excellent infrequently asked question. Henning.
How come that Labour in a general election only got 37% of the votes but still have got the absolute majority in House of Commons?
That's a proportional representation thing. It ensures stability of government, you know. So it's not funny, answer, but it is true. How about you, Catherine?
What on earth is a Sith? And is it just an anagram?
This.
Hits.
He's a Sith.
Sith is Star Wars collect question.
Oh, a Sith.
Yeah.
I think it's a Sith Lord.
Sith is what Jif used to be, not Jif Lem and the other one. But a Sith.
Maybe that's
Sith.
What it means. Revenge is the Jif Lem.
A Sith is a bad Jedus.
Oh, okay.
Jedi.
One Jedus, many Jedi.
Well, but
it's
I wouldn't
Latin.
To ask any more questions this week.
It's well known that they speak Latin in the galaxy.
Hang on. They're not called
well,
the Jedus.
A long time ago. No,
Jedus.
They're not. No, you're right, they're not.
Are you one of those people who does that?
No, I'm not. So what's your most infrequently asked question?
Mine is, why in soaps? I can't do this. He told me this one. Why is it in soaps that they don't swear? So they go, you know, they stab someone and they go, you do it.
It's like the way in soaps that the hard man always stabs somebody, goes, you bleeder.
See? That's what I was going to do.
Just do that.
Why is it in soaps that the man stabs someone, goes, you bleeder, and they don't say, you bastard.
Would anyone else like to do a cover of that joke?
During the start of Paul McCartney.
That's it for part one. In part two, I'm going to be replaced by a rather special guest. Does this mystery voice sound familiar? Hello, I'm David Mitchell, and I'll be your host for part two of Fact You. Who is that? Find out after the break.
Nintendo DS, in touch with original comedy. Touch me.
I'm not your dad.
It's all right.
Sometimes life's more than a 3-minute conversation. Talk for up to 60 minutes, pay for just 3 with Vodafone.
Does using dramatic hair colour mean you risk losing the shine? Not with new Fearless Colour from Herbal Essences. Unlike most hair colours, it has an ammonia-free liquid gel and up to 6 weeks' supply of Evershine conditioning gloss, giving you stunning colour and up to 35% more shine, guaranteed to get you noticed. New Fearless Colour from Herbal Essences. Bring your colour out of the shade.
Herbal Essences.
One of the most beautiful digital still cameras is a phone. 100% camera, 100% phone. The beautiful new SF65. Siemens.
You First means a bank that's in step with you. Like our new Note for Note program. You donate the spare pennies from your account each month. And we'll donate too. Note for Note, Music for Schools programme. Just one of the ways we're working to put you first. Sign up at LloydsTSB.com.
This motorcyclist never knew what hit him. Over half of motorcyclists killed or seriously injured in London last year were hit. Looking, but not seeing. Riding defensively gives you more time to see and be seen. Look out for the driver that didn't see you.
Gordon's. The colourful gin.
Together with Canon, you can.
You're not gonna go in, are you?
Look how detailed this is.
All those figures, they're real people.
You can visit, but you can't leave. House of Wax, only in cinemas.
Dad, I'm gay.
Excellent.
Sometimes life's more than a three-minute conversation. Talk for up to 60 minutes, pay for just three with Vodafone.
This is the canvas your telephone's been cleared off of!
Get ready for Johnny Regis.
Burn the people! Show no fear! I am not a TV presenter!
18 Stone of Idiot starts 27th of May on 4.
Nintendo DS, in touch with original comedy. Touch me.
Hello and welcome back to Fact You. I'm here with Catherine Jakeways, Rhys Thomas, Henning Vane and Frankie Boyle. And if the world ended right now, I would die a happy man. So, God, if you're thinking of wrapping things up, now would be a good time. No? Right, OK, on with the inevitable 50 years of decline. What a pisser. Now, is there a single thing in the world that women can do better than men? Well, yes, there is. According to scientists at the University of Heidelberg, women can become addicted to alcohol more quickly than men and suffer brain damage sooner from drinking. Well done, ladies. One in the eye for men everywhere. So my frequently asked question is, should there be a limit on what women are allowed to drink? Catherine?
Should there be a limit on what women are allowed to drink?
You know, the amount.
When I get drunk, I always claim not to be drunk. And right. I was quite drunk recently, and my boyfriend filmed me on his mobile thing of me.
Finger.
Yeah, on his mobile finger. Yeah. He's got this weird sort of big brother type finger. Yeah. No, but I was absolutely all over the place, and I was going on about how I wasn't drunk and how nobody should let me drive and things.
Did you drive then?
No, I would never drive.
You're saying I wasn't drunk and nobody should let you drive, so you prefer to drive when you are drunk.
I've always said...
I don't let me drive, I haven't got the nerve for it yet. if I've had a couple, then I'm okay.
The best way to drink and drive is with a hand over one eye. Because you can do it. I've done it. You know, you drink driving. I don't think there's anything that wrong with it.
It's very bad to drink drive.
Oh, come on. Only in the 20th century. You know, not long ago, they did it in the 1560s.
They burned witches in the 1560s.
No.
It's a major way that people die. I'm not saying it wouldn't be worse if everyone was pissed, but I'm still saying that's no defence for driving pissed.
Yeah, the thing is, you're not taking your driving test pissed, are you? He's not going, when I slap the dashboard, I want you to nip out and get us both a kebab.
Now, that would be fair enough. If you've passed the test pissed, you should be allowed to drive pissed. But if you were sober when you pass the test, you should drive sober.
It's like automatic and manual, isn't it?
Yeah,
you
exactly. Yeah. That three states, automatic, manual, and pissed.
That's good. Yeah.
What do they do to you in Germany if you drink drive?
They don't have a speed limit in Germany.
So, yeah, I had to give to hand back my driver's license, but I got it back then after 18 months.
Oh, you drank drive?
Yeah, they nicked me.
No wonder you were keeping so quiet.
Yeah, but that wasn't, because that was at the time when I still lived at home, so... And usually I would have been in for a ride bollocking from my father. I met to him 2 weeks before that.
Frankie, what do you think? Should there be a limit on what women and, say, also Germans are allowed to drink?
There should be a limit on women, definitely. They should be limited on drinking just at the point where they're about to start singing karaoke. I think it should be like the drink driving test, where they go, will you blow into this bag? With women, they should just stick a microphone through the window and go, do you fancy giving us a song into this? Well, get out of the car then. why are they always singing karaoke, My Heart Will Go On? And you're sitting there going, well, good, because your liver's fucked.
Wicked.
There's an ideal amount of drink for a woman, in my opinion. Just enough to find me attractive, but without the extra unit that would make that a lethal dose. Now, what's the best way to address the issue of homelessness? Well, German Senator Peter Gleustein decided the best way was to get a big bottle of sparkling wine and pour it over the head of a confused homeless man at the opening ceremony of German Wine Week. The stunt was a huge success, and as a result, there's been a massive surge of interest in German homeless people. But my frequently asked question is this. What is it with the Germans? Henning.
Yeah, what is it with the homeless?
The homeless Germans? What is it with them?
In that case, what makes me really angry is, that person definitely has got a lack of financial funds. We wouldn't be homeless. Yeah. So, but instead of going and look out for work or whatever, he just dilly-dallies about a posh wine fest. Yeah. So, and therefore, what I would suggest, my grandfather, after the war, he didn't have a job. So, but he didn't go to a posh wine fest and lament how unfair life was on him. He did something about it. He got on his bike and looked for work. And that is what I can only recommend to that one geezer there.
No. To be fair, there probably weren't that many wine festivals in Germany in the immediate aftermath of the Second World War. There were other priorities, the rebuilding of the whole country. They thought, this is probably not the time we'd all love a wine festival, but for God's sake, let's rebuild the cities. Then we'll have a wine festival round about 1953.
Be honest. Right? Be honest now.
Yeah.
Homeless people, I do feel sorry for them, but a lot of the time, they have got a choice. I could have been homeless if I decided to leave my home and just not go back there anymore, but I don't do it.
Yeah. No, I don't think the problem is not that we all couldn't be homeless if we wanted to be, but that not all of us can be homed despite wanting to be.
Yeah, but
we could all be homeless, but homeless people couldn't have homes.
But
they want homes, they're homeless.
They've got lovely dogs that are brand new and clean and pedigreed.
They don't call themselves the dogless.
The thing is, you see a homeless guy out with his dog, if he freezes to death at Christmas, they'll take that dog and find it a home.
They don't find a home.
Why can't we do that with people? We should have a programme like Tramp Rescue. Do you enjoy playing pool? Endless long walks and drinking. Perhaps you could provide a home for Kenny.
We never put a healthy tramp down. But as there's no such thing as a healthy tramp, we kill quite a lot of them. I think that's a horrible thing to do, pour wine over a homeless person. I mean, imagine being homeless and smelling of booze. Now, a search has started in order to find the identity of a mute pianist who was found soaking wet on the Isle of Sheppey. The man has said nothing for a month, doesn't know who he is, and does nothing but play the piano all day, like a demented Jules Holland with amnesia. So my question is, if you were washed up on a beach with no memory, what's the one skill you'd like to retain?
Is this man Bach? maybe it's Bach. And that's who he is, and that's who he is.
Are you saying it like that to impress David?
Yeah, you've heard his
movements. Works. However, Bach is dead.
Yeah, maybe not. Maybe he's just forgotten he's dead, and he's turned up now on the Isle of Sheppey.
Yeah, no, we know Bach is dead.
How?
Where's
well,
the facts?
I don't know. How do you know anyone's dead? Well, they die and they get buried and you know they're dead.
Well, have you ever seen Bach's grave?
No, I haven't got permanent... I haven't got personal
proof. Well, you've got no proof, then.
I haven't got personal proof of the death of Bach. But then I'm willing to accept, you know, received wisdom about a lot of people who were born hundreds of years ago and who, therefore, are presumably dead. When somebody first told me, David, by the way, Bach is dead, I didn't go, oh, there's no way he's dead. Come on, this is some sort of conspiracy. How come he's dead? He'd only be 200.
The Pope died recently, didn't he?
Yeah, again, I have no proof. I didn't see him die, but I believe it.
We saw him.
He was old, he looked fucked. Someone tells me he's dead, I believe it.
To be honest, I thought he was dead for the last few months of his reign.
So, what skill would you like to retain? Henning.
I'm very, very good at sunbathing.
Oh. Oh.
You know what he means.
Yeah.
That's not a skill as such, is it? Just lying prone.
No, but it's all about that you don't get cancer. So, and that is where the skill is involved. It's just all up here. If I'm there in that situation, I decide for myself I won't get cancer, and then you can bet a tenner on that I won't get cancer.
What if you get cancer up here? You know, you say it's all up here. You get brain cancer.
Can you?
Oh, yeah. You can get brain cancer.
Yeah, I'm not doing that either.
Right.
So, that's a good skill to retain.
I think the skill to resist cancer would be a great skill on a desert island or anywhere. Frankie Boyle, what skill would you like to retain?
Schizophrenia would be useful, wouldn't it? Yeah. Because you'd be very lonely in your desert island for a while. And then you'd be like, oh, Mr. Sebastian. Oh, hello, Mr. Boyle. Shall we go and get some coconuts today? Oh, yes, that would be fantastic, Mr. Boyle. Oh, look, people are coming. No, they're not. I've just gone even madder.
I can knit.
Can you?
My mum taught me to knit when I was very young.
Do you enjoy knitting?
Not really, but I can do it.
But it wouldn't be an escape for your inner pain if you were washed up on a beach.
I could knit myself a bridge to another island, and then sort of walk across it.
Yeah.
With I don't know what I'd use. There's no sheep. Is there sheep on this island? Where's
yeah, there can be sheep. Whatever. Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's have fun. If you're knitting a bridge, I'll allow sheep.
I'm going to knit a bridge.
Yeah.
That's okay. The skill I'd like to retain.
You'd like to retain the skill of knitting because it's very useful to escape with.
Yeah.
Nintendo DS and MacPix. In touch with original comedy. Touch me.
New from the Comedy Lab, next up, I'm Spasticus. And then Charlotte gets her prim kit off. It's her birthday in Double Sex and the City.
Spend so much time being polite to people, turning up and saying, oh, I'm so sorry I'm late. There was a traffic, oh, awful, and I had to perform a trichotomy on a camel with just using a garden shears. It was very, very difficult, very, very sorry. Just be honest with these people. Come in and say, I knew you were